I first learned of the Gerrish 345 Falconry Hood while on a Falconry Facebook page called DIY Falconry. After seeing it there, I endeavored to make one for myself. I made the hood, and I really like it. Here's how I made mine. Before we begin, I'll briefly discuss what you'll need to make this hood. I've provided more information in the video description, but if you'd still like to know more, don't hesitate to leave a comment. To make this hood, you'll need a pattern, leather, a pen, scissors, waxed thread, a needle, a hole punch, a razor, and super glue. Now let's get started. The first thing you're going to need is your pattern. To get your pattern, you will have to download the hood pattern generator developed by Mark Thiessen, which you can find and download by following the link provided. There are several hood styles to choose from. Make sure the 345 one is selected. It allows you to give measurements in inches and in millimeters. I've selected millimeters. As shown, it also explains how to measure your hock to find the correct size. I've measured my hock to find it to be 60 millimeters across. I entered this measurement in the box and hit print. Now that you have your pattern, we can get started on the hood. Now the next step is to trace the pattern on the back side of your leather. Next, you're going to cut along the traced lines. I cut out the beak opening first. You'll cut out the rest of the pattern. Alright, now I like to take a larger needle and punch the holes for where my stitches are going to go, which I'll then use my wax thread with a smaller needle. But before you start, you always want to wet your area down thoroughly with water. This just keeps the leather from breaking, makes it a little bit more pliable and durable for stitching, prevents damage. Now, as I said, I like to go through with a larger needle and punch the holes where I'll be placing my stitches. Now we're going to stitch it following our holes using a cross stitch method. Starting at the top, I'm just going to pull it through, take off our needle, leave a little bit hanging out there, and then take the other end of our string, restring the needle, and begin our cross stitch down that side. Alright, so once you've finished stitching along this edge diagonally, I like to just place a few straight across stitches through the last two holes just to strengthen the bond here at the bottom. Just like that. And then we'll start back up going diagonally, zigzagging in the opposite direction to create our cross stitch. And we'll just do this, working our way all the way back to the top. Once you get to the top, you just need to, on that final stitch, just drive your needle straight inside the hood. And if you remember, we've got the other end of our string already inside there. I just use a couple granny knots, cover it in super glue, and then trim your string. Now I take my super glue, cover that knot, and using my finger I just squish the knot as far up into that corner as I can. Now you'll repeat this procedure here on the other side. At this point your hood should look something like this. Now our next step is going to be to make the top knot for this hood. To do this you'll first need to cut three small slits in the very top and center of your hood. About right here, here, and here. Next, you'll need to cut a strip of leather about this thick and this long. This is going to be our top knot. You're going to fold it till the ends meet and line up, and then press firmly to create a crease right in the middle of the strip. On this crease, you're going to take your hole punch and punch a hole. Then, once you've punched your hole, you're going to take scissors and cut one side of this strip to be thinner than the other side. Like this. Then, you'll take a razor and the width of this strip, you'll cut slits wide enough for it to pull through. You're now ready to insert it into your hood. We'll start by taking our thick end in a pair of pliers and going down the hole farthest from the beak opening. We'll push the skinny side through the very front slit. And you'll line up this hole over the center slit. Pull both ends together up through the center slit through the hole. So then your hood should look like this. Next, we'll pass this thinner strip through these loops all the way up through the top. Using water, I was able to mold the top knot into a shape that I liked. Now that we've got our top knot done, we can start on our braces. To make your braces, you'll first need to carve three slits onto the bottom of each side of the hood. Your slits should look like this. Now you'll need to make your braces. You can make your braces by cutting thin strips of leather or by using Gore-Tex. You can buy Gore-Tex braces from most online falconry vendors. Making them, however, is still the same process. I have another video specifically on this process. You fold the top, punch a hole through the fold. So I've punched my holes, and I can now draw the brace through this hole to create what's called the button. At the 1.5 inch mark where you did your slit, you're going to want to punch a hole on both braces, still leaving one brace without a slit. You're now ready to install your braces. I've provided a link to a video that specifically details the process of installing braces in the video description. Follow that link if you don't know how to install braces. The next thing you'll want to do is fully saturate your hood with water. The reason why we're doing this is so we can form the hood with our fingers, and then when it dries to that form, it'll fit the hawk's head better. Once you've got the hood fully soaked, just use your fingers and mold the hood so that it's rounded and more contoured for a hawk's head. As you can see, the hood now has more contour and is more rounded and generally looks better. Now the hood is technically finished. However, there is one last thing, which is decorating. Dye the hood with whatever color you want, or just leave the hood undyed. I really just like the black dye with Super Sheen finish, both Tandy products. And we'll just apply it liberally all over the hood and let it soak in and dry. Our hood is now complete. The only thing left to do is try it on the Hawk. As you can see, the hood fits, and it fits her nicely. However, you can also see that the beak opening is not a perfect fit. Yours probably won't be either when you finish your hood, so you'll have to trim and adjust the beak opening until it fits perfectly, not rubbing or making contact with the beak anywhere.